Hello people, in today's video I'm going to be showing something different. So far I've not seen this on YouTube, or maybe I'm not able to find it. I'm going to be covering how to replace the hub rubber of Dominar. Now what do you mean by hub rubber? So these are some samples what you can see now. I've purchased from Bajaj. I'll leave the part number at the end. I'll leave a photo of the part number at the end. But these come between the hub and the chain sprocket mount. So between these two mounts, so that the metal do not brush each other, there are rubbers. Now in my bike, I've got play. So once you see this, okay, here I put the gear bike in first gear and there is a play. Okay, you can see after the chain stops still the tire moves. So I need, this is because of the play in the rubber. Okay, these are hard rubbers, so they do wear out because of high speed riding, or you know, quick shifts, or because of high speed braking, etc, etc. I mean, we all know that rubber parts wear and tear. So now what we need to do is we need to remove the axle, we need to remove the chain aside, the sprocket aside, and take the wheel off, put the rubbers, and then put the hub back and the chain, etc, back. So in this video I'll be covering all this. So my wheel is now off. This sits in here, this part. Okay, it sits in here while on this notch, and the brakes fit in the disc for obvious reasons. The chain is usually on this, so once you've loosened it and put the tire completely inside, okay, the chain is like this. Okay, you can then loosen the chain and keep it aside like this. Okay, then take the tire, put this aside here, don't stretch it much, do it very slowly, and for obvious reasons the bike needs to be on the paddock. Okay, so the wheel is off. I'll try to take, okay, hub is off too. Now these are the rubbers that I've been talking about. Okay, if you see, they are very loose. Okay, we need to change all these six rubbers. So I'll clean this chamber with a cloth. I'll remove all the dust and debris and all. Okay, we can inspect the bearing seems to be nice. So I'll lube this bearing too. Okay, while fixing it back, I'll have to lube the axle too. If you don't have grease at home, you can do it with 90 number oil, or worst case you can do it with a regular oil, or even your chain lube. So while fixing it, make sure it is not dry. While putting it back, make sure it is not dry. You need to lube these parts and put it back so that they don't rust. Here's my wheel hub, now completely clean, neat and tidy. Okay, so I've brought my chain lube that I've been using of late. It's from Arochem. I'll be lubing the bearings with it, since I don't have special bearing chain lube. I've also got my grease and oil that I'll be using on these on the axles and chain and everywhere, wherever required. This video, this part of the video, I was specially want to tell you that, you know, when you're planning to clean this part, you'll have to lean the tire somewhere so that you can clean this. So make sure when you're leaning, the disc does not get damaged or touch the ground directly. Okay, if you see, I've left enough space from all sides. The disc should not get scratched or you know, weight should not come on the disc. So when you're making tire puncture repairs or anything, or wheels are being changed, make sure that your wheel is not kept in such a way where the pressure is coming on the disc. So I've added one new rubber and one old rubber just to show you the difference in play. If you see, I can hardly move this rubber, okay, but this one, it is moving quite a lot. So this is the play that comes in. Okay, this does not have much play. It is moving, but it is coming out. It is not moving left and right. It's hardly, I mean, there's hardly any space. But this one is moving quite a lot. Okay. So this is the reason why hub rubber needs to be changed, because of this play. Now, as I told you earlier, the play comes in because of high speed riding, because the hub getting hot and the rubber is getting hot and the rubber is wearing out, and so on. So if you see these part inside, if you see, they are brushed here, okay, they are brushed inside at these parts out here, okay. Now in case if you are on a tour or something and you're traveling and you feel that there's play come in and you want to fix that play and you're not able to find these rubbers anywhere, so if you can go to any puncture wala, they'll be having the old tubes, okay. So what you can do is you can ask them to cut one of the tube parts, okay, put it over here, okay, wrap it up here, one from this side and like this here, and then put the old rubber like this. So that way the play will reduce, and you would at least be able to ride back to your home or to the next destination where you can find proper wheel hub rubbers. So rubbers are just need to be slided inside, okay, nothing to be done here. Don't lube the rubbers or you know much over here, just slide them inside and you're done. So all the six rubbers are in place now. So I'll just put the I'll just clean and put this chain hub back, and then the tire will go inside. So we are all done now. The wheel is back in place, chain is lubed. One hint I would like to give. So when you're removing the chain, when you're removing the hub, when you're removing the wheel completely out, make sure that you remember your chain setting, okay? And when you're fixing it back, the chain setting should not change. It should be the same. Because of the play, the chain might loosen out and you might need to tighten it out, but at least it should not go inside. So this will ensure that your you know, all your fitting is in place. So if you see, my chain is moving very smoothly now, okay, everything's in place, the wheel is rotating absolutely smoothly, okay, the brakes are working fine, okay, so everything's back in place. And we finally check once where the play was, if you can see the play back or not. I'll put the bike in first gear again and let's see if we have any play or not. See, the play is all gone now. I mean, we don't see double movements, we see only one movement. As soon as the chain moves, the wheel also moves. As soon as the chain stops, the wheel also stops. Earlier the wheel was going ahead and I mean to and fro a little more even after the chain location stopped.